In this video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to accept Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies in your Shopify stores. But before we hop into my computer and I show you how it's done, what are the benefits of this? You know, we see all these major companies today, like Overstock.com just started accepting crypto. Tesla lets you buy a car off their website with Bitcoin. And of course, you could still head on down to Orange County Lamborghini and buy a brand new Lamborghini 100% with Bitcoin. You know, the famous Bitcoin Lamborghini that went around YouTube here a while back, no matter what your opinions of that are. But one of the big benefits is instant payments. When someone pays you with crypto, it's yours, no questions asked. Technically, the blockchain for Bitcoin and Bitcoin Cash isn't instant, but all I mean is there's no middleman. There's no credit card processing company that's got to process the payment, no bank account that's got to transfer your money, and of course, there's no companies like PayPal who are going to hold your money for 60 days, and then they also, you know, cover buyer's remorse. You know, the customer just says, yeah, I changed my mind. PayPal jacks the money out of your account, gives it back to them, and they get a free item. You know, that's a story for another day, but we actually took PayPal off of all our Shopify stores a while back because we were losing so much money. You know, I think when people are starting out, that's another thing they don't realize, and that's going to be a good segue to the second benefit. When you own a large 6- or 7-figure e-commerce business like we do, you don't realize how much time and money you waste just fighting people who are trying to defraud you and get free stuff from you. You know, all the fraudulent chargebacks and all the fees that come along with it, and PayPal disputes and everything else. Speaking of PayPal, or speaking of Tesla, I wish Elon Musk would get some free time in the future, buy back PayPal, and straighten out that damn company. But again, that's a story for another day. So just the nature of Bitcoin and cryptocurrency itself, it's encrypted, it's safe. You know, it's also really good for high ticket items if you're selling things like that or services. It's a great way just to guarantee payments and just help you sleep better at night. But anyways, guys, those were only a couple of the benefits. We're gonna hop onto my computer right now. I'm gonna show you guys how to set this up, and I'll see you guys over there.
The internet is gonna reach its full potential, which is gonna be, I think, 10 times greater. Every industry in the world is going to be affected. And it's going to be a beautiful thing. This is the new internet, it's the upgrade.
Alright guys, so here we are in the back end of one of our Shopify stores, and this is the one that we want to enable crypto payments on. So first, if you're on your dashboard, you want to navigate down to the bottom left and click on Settings. And from there, you want to click on Payment Providers. And from this page, you'll be able to see all your standard payment options, such as Shopify Payments, which is essentially Stripe. It's one of the bigger credit card processing companies. The Shopify Payments version of it is just a little more tailor-made for accepting payments through Shopify. There's a few more limitations, but it's a lot more convenient as well. Which, by the way, as a quick side note before we move on, if you guys ever did have problems with Shopify Payments, let's say maybe the product you're selling isn't accepted by them or something like that, if you click on Edit right here, you can look at your different settings for that, but you could also go to Change Provider, and you're gonna have access to a ton of different credit card processing companies here. So if you guys wanna try another one, like 2Checkout is a great one, I've used them before. Skrill is great for some more like high risk items, but there's a lot of other options in here if you had trouble with Shopify payments. But on that note, let's move on and let's start accepting crypto. So I'll close out of this. We're gonna scroll down. As I mentioned before, we do have PayPal disabled and just ask for a world of trouble in my opinion, but that's for another video. Amazon payments is another great one to have enabled, but what we're looking for is the alternative payment section. Now, if we go down here, you're gonna see we have access to all these different third-party payment gateways. The main ones we're gonna be looking at here is Coinbase Commerce, which is just a different division of Coinbase. It's like their merchant account system. We have BitPay, which we're also gonna be taking a look at. And we also have GoCoin. The first one we're gonna be setting up is Coinbase Commerce. So I'm gonna click on that. If we go down here, you can see that once we enable this, we create our account and put in our credentials right here. We're gonna be able to accept Ethereum, Bitcoin, Litecoin, and of course, Bitcoin Cash, just like if these were like credit card options. As you can see, they're very similar icons to the ones that we saw just above. Now, let's go ahead. We're gonna hop over to Coinbase Commerce, set up our account, and then plug in our details right here. So here we are on their website. You guys can just go ahead, Google Coinbase Commerce, or the link will be down in the description. There's no affiliate link or anything like that. And we're just gonna click on Get Started, and we'll begin setting up our account. So I'm gonna use my secondary email right here, and we'll create a password. We'll click I agree to terms of service. As usual, I'm going to hold it to you guys to read every damn word of their terms of service, as most people do, of course. And I'm going to click on sign up. And we just need to verify our email, so I'm going to do that really quick, and I will be right back. We're going to click on continue to dashboard. And the first thing you want to do from here is click on secure access to your account. And what you need to do now, if you don't have it already, is you need to download the Google Authenticator app. You're going to download that, open it up, scan this QR code, and it's going to give you a verification to log in. You're also going to use the same method every time you log into your Coinbase Commerce account. Now, two-factor authentication is normally associated with SMS. Like, you'll sign into something, they'll say, check the text that we sent you with the four-digit code or whatever. SMS, unfortunately, like a lot of other things, is actually very insecure. If you ever have the option to choose between verifying with SMS for two-factor authentication or using an authenticator app like Google's, always go with the latter. So I'm gonna do that really quick here on my end. I'm gonna scan the barcode and it's giving me the code to log in. So the code is gonna be 692785. Unless you're making a tutorial video like this, I hope you're not sharing that password with anyone. Kind of defeats the whole point. I'll click on confirm. And here we are inside of our main dashboard. Now, once you've done that, it's also gonna ask you for your basic information, like your billing address, some other information about your account, where they should deposit funds to. So just go ahead, fill that out, and it's gonna bring you to your standard dashboard like this. Now, to connect this account to your Shopify store, all you have to do is go down to where you have your API keys. We're gonna click on reveal. I'm gonna click on copy. We'll navigate back to Shopify. And the first thing we want to do is we want to insert our email address that we signed up to our account with right here. And we're just going to paste our API key in here. I'm going to click on save. And that's it. You're good to go. So now people have the option of paying with Bitcoin, Ethereum, Bitcoin Cash, and Litecoin is also included in there as well. And that's all going to go directly into your Coinbase account. I know a lot of you, if you're especially starting out with crypto, you probably have a Coinbase account already. So it's going to be pretty convenient. Now, the next one I want to look at is BitPay. A lot of people prefer BitPay over Coinbase because they do have some like privacy and security concerns. Personally, if you want to know what I use, I do use Coinbase Commerce. I'm totally fine with that. I sleep just fine at night. But if you want to use BitPay, I'm going to show you how to set that up right now. So I'm going to go back in here and I'm going to disable Coinbase Commerce. I'll click on edit and deactivate. Once that loads back up, we're going to go back to select additional payment method and we're going to choose BitPay. So very similar process. BitPay does only accept Bitcoin. So you're not going to be able to accept Ethereum or Bitcoin Cash or anything like that yet. I'm just assuming that they're going to expand into those down the road, but right now it's only going to let your customers pay with Bitcoin. So to set up our account with that, I'm going to head over to the BitPay website. I'm going to click on start now. And what we want to do is select a business account. So I'll click on that and we'll go to sign up. So just like before, we're going to enter our basic info. We'll go create a password. We'll click on agree. I'm not a robot. At least last time I checked, I wasn't. And we'll click on create account. And just like before, go into your email and verify your account really quick. I'm gonna do that and I'll be right back. I'm gonna log back in. And once you've done that, the next thing you need to do is verify the rest of your information. So just like Coinbase Commerce, you're gonna fill out the rest of the information about your business, where to deposit funds and all that stuff. So we'll click on get verified. I'm gonna fill all this out and I'll be right back. And there we go. And once you've done that, all you need to do is tell them where to send your Bitcoin payments to. Now you can have BitPay automatically convert your Bitcoin into US dollars and put it into a bank account, or you could just enter your Bitcoin wallet address, which I'm gonna do right here. So I'll click on add bank account, add Bitcoin address. We're gonna enter the name. So that's just gonna be my personal account. I'm gonna paste that in here. And there we go. So once you've verified your account and entered all your info, you wanna click on start accepting Bitcoin. Now to integrate your BitPay account with Shopify, you wanna click on payment tools on the left-hand side. You're gonna scroll down and you wanna create a new legacy API key. So I'm gonna click on that. We're gonna go add new API key. We're gonna click on edit. You could go ahead and name this in case you wanna use BitPay on multiple different websites or different tools, or you're accepting it in different ways. So I'm just gonna label mine Shopify for right now. Confirm and save. And we're gonna copy our API key right here. And just like before, we'll navigate back to Shopify and we'll paste it right here. Now, once you've done that, we'll click on save and you're all set. All right, guys, so that's how you can go ahead and start accepting Bitcoin, other cryptocurrencies in your Shopify stores. If you guys like this video, please click the subscribe button down below. You guys have really enjoyed the last couple of videos and I plan doing a lot more of these now this summer. Also, if you like this video and you got something out of it, click the like button down below.
Also, if you guys want links to all the tools and the websites that we use in the video, they're going to be down below in the description, as well as a written guide step-by-step how to do it if you don't want to watch the video over again. So I'm glad you guys got something out of this video. My name is Matthew Sabia, and I'll see you guys next time.